Climate change is on the world's agenda, and increasingly there is a focus on how business will respond. We spoke to Stephen Elliott, CIA Chief Executive, about the importance of the chemical industry and how it can play its part.
So Stephen, welcome. First of all, climate change, huge issue on the political agenda at the moment. What more would you like to see the government doing now?
I think huge political issue, and an issue that has really grabbed the attention of the public as well. So governments need to respond, industry needs to respond. And I think what we would like to see the government to do is recognise the role that we're already playing in tackling this issue. That's both in terms of what we directly can do, reduce our own emissions, and over the past 30 years we've done that to the extent of 42%, huge achievement for the industry, but also the indirect role we can play opposite the products that our ingredients go into, if you like, and the products that you and I depend upon for our everyday living. So for every one ton of CO2 that we directly emit in producing something, the saving for a customer can be as much as 2.5 to 3 times that.
What are your members now telling you about decarbonisation, and what are you doing to support them?
CIA is doing a number of things to support the industry in addressing climate change, decarbonisation, and also staying competitive, because we are globally exposed in terms of our trade and investment opportunities. For the past 15 years or so, we have been working with the government on something called the Climate Change Levy. That brings a collective agreement from businesses in the chemical sector. We agree a target around energy efficiency with the government for a period of time, and we respond to that. And over the past 15 years or so, we have regularly beaten that target. What that does do is it reduces emissions, but it also gives a rebate on the levy that the government introduced. So there's an incentive all round there.
Sustainability. What's the CIA doing now to move towards a more sustainable future?
Well, with sustainability, there's a fantastic opportunity for, again, chemicals and chemical businesses and chemistry. If you look ahead to 2030, our population, global population, is going to grow to 8.5 billion. That's another billion people. The demand for food will go up by 35%. The demand for water will go up by 40%. And the demand for energy will go up by 50%. Those are tremendous opportunities for a sector like ours that provides solutions into all of that. But at the same time, it obviously presents a challenge, because the whole world wants to develop. The whole world will therefore demand ever more sophisticated products, and many of those require energy. So there's a big challenge to make sure that we do that as efficiently as possible while grasping the opportunity related to every individual on the planet's ambition.
Thinking ahead to the next 10, 20, 30 years, what's the industry doing now to support the next generation of people who'll be coming into your industry?
Yeah, for the chemical industry and science-based industries, I think we're really looking to do two things. One is improve the awareness and understanding of science in the general population. And that begins at primary school level. That begins with parents talking to their kids and taking that through to secondary and beyond. If we can get that basic improvement in understanding of science, great. Beyond that, we want to attract and retain people in our industry. We're a relatively mature industry, but the future is evidently younger people. So we're doing a lot of work to attract young people and to retain them, most specifically with our Future Forum initiative, which brings together younger people in the industry, and they have a self-help network, if you like, which we also manage and encourage.
At the moment, our future with Europe in Europe is looking fairly tumultuous. What are you now doing as an industry body to support your members and everybody within it?
Yeah, very volatile, uncertain times. And I think it's the uncertainty that is most difficult for business, because that's what business craves. It can deal with all sorts of situations, but as long as there's some predictability around those situations. We haven't had that for more than 3 years now, if we think about Brexit. Our industry, it's its own biggest customer, and our biggest market is Europe. 60% of all of our chemical exports head to the 27 countries in the European Union. 75% of all of our imports come from the 27 countries of the European Union. So whatever the outcome on this, and we hope there's some clarity and certainty around that outcome, what we must do is retain that commercial connection.
And finally, where do you see the future of the chemical industry now going into 2019, 2020?
I think we get some certainty in terms of the overall political climate. We look to take advantage of the opportunities presented by sustainability and decarbonisation, as much as they are challenges. But these are really exciting times, because tackling those global challenges, which people are increasingly aware of, concerned about, they can only be resolved through chemicals and chemistry.
Stephen Elliott, thanks very much for joining us.